remembrance of Awliya Ikram. I will come to this point, inshallah, that why I mention the opportunity about remembering Awliya Ikram. It is understood to remember Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam.
But there can be some doubts. How could we find Ramadan or other acts of worship be taken as a remembrance of Awliya Ikram? Inshallah, Allah says, I will try to come to that point as well later. My dear brothers, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has given us an opportunity to be engaged more and more in this worship. If we were doing sadaqah, apart from Ramadan, we have to do more during the month of Ramadan. Again, it doesn't mean that we have to reduce after the month of Ramadan. We should continue this even after the month of Ramadan. If we are engaged in offering prayer by Jama'at behind the Sunni scholar during the month of Ramadan, after the Ramadan as well, we should be in this practice to offer prayer behind the Imam who is a true scholar of the during the month of Ramadan. If we are getting up early in order to perform the Hajj, even after the month of Ramadan, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala may bless us with the tawfiq to offer the Hajj prayers even apart from Ramadan. My dear brothers, in short again, this is an opportunity to gain quiet, to gain taqwa, to refrain from sins, to seek the pleasure of Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by doing more and more deeds, and by refraining from all kinds of haram which has to be refrained even apart from Ramadan, but also from those things which are doubtful. By doing this, whether I will get a reward, or by doing this, whether I will get a sin, if you have such a doubt, still you have to prevent, you have to refrain from that act which is doubtful. This is also the part of taqwa. To be a person of piety, to gain, to be a pious person, not only that, we should fulfill all the orders of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala which have been ordained on us. Also, we should follow the sunnah of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We should try to act on mustahabbat, even the nawafil, and also we should refrain from haram, even from makruh, and also from those acts which are doubtful. If we do that, inshallah, Aziz, we can gain piety. Awliya of Allah, they did the same. They acted on all the orders of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They refrained from all kinds of haram, makruh, and all doubtful things. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, with His blessings, blessed them so much that they attained such a status, such a rank, which we cannot comprehend, which we cannot understand. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has stated, as per the hadith al-Qudsi, awliyai tahta sibai la ya'rifuhum ghayri. Allah ta'ala stated that my awliya, my friends, they are under my rahmat, they are under my special blessings, and no one is aware of them except me. No one is aware of them except Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. The meaning can be taken this way also, that the status, the rank of a wali of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, we cannot understand that. We cannot comprehend the status, the maqam of a wali of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, because Allah ta'ala has stated, they are under my special rahmah, and they are such that no one is aware of their status than me. Allahu Akbar. And by the given knowledge of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to His Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is well aware of each person's rank and status. Allahu Akbar. My dear brothers, so this is an opportunity to seek the pleasure of Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to be pious during the month of Ramadan, and to be pious even after the month of Ramadan, making it a practice for the entire life till the death. And if سبحان الله. At the time of their death, at the time when they will leave this world, angels will descend. The malaika, they will come to this earth, to that person, and they will say, Allah takhafu, do not fear, wa la tahzanu, do not grieve, wa abashiru bil jannah. We are giving you the glad tidings of Jannah, which was promised for you. SubhanAllah, nahnu awliyaukum, we are your friends. Hayatid dunya, in this dunya, wa fil akhirah, even in the next dunya, we are your friends. Who says? Angels will say, and angels say by the order of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, this is Quran, nahnu awliyaukum, fil hayatid dunya, we are your friends, we are your helpers, we are your supporters in this world. That means Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has kept his angels, his malaika, his rasul, his awliya, supporters. So this is a clear indication that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has made us supporters. Allah ta'ala has made awliya and angels as supporters. So if we call angels for the help, if we call prophets for the help, if we call awliya for the help, this can never be shirk, because this is by the order of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Allah has stated that angels will say, nahnu awliyaukum, we are your friends, fil hayati dunya, in this world, wa fil akhirah, even in the next world. Allah, my dear brothers, so if we can make use of this opportunity, we can gain piety. But again, remember one more thing. Just by doing good deeds, just by performing 50 hajj in his lifetime, just by performing hundreds of umrah, having all the salah behind an imam, whether he is a Wahhabi or Sunni or whatever, doing all kinds of good deeds, sadaqah, charity, zakat, whatever, everything you do for the rest of the lifetime, if you are not perfect in the love of Rasul Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are not going to benefit from anything. And also, even if you are perfect, even if you are firm in your ibadah, even if you are perfect in giving charities, in doing ibadah, still Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has blessed you. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has to bless you. Then only you will reach that status of wilayah. Not only Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given the station of wilayah to Sayyidina Ali al-Murtada radiallahu ta'ala anhu. That means to gain wilayah, to attain piety, to have the friendship of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, you have to bend under the dome of Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala. If not, you can. You can't get success. You can't be success. You can't attain wilayah, because Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated, oh my sahaba, don't you believe? Are you not aware that I am closer to the believers than their own selves? SubhanAllah, this is the tafsir of the Quran as well. An-Nabiyyu awla bil mu'minina min anfusihim. Allah Ta'ala stated, my Nabi is closer to the believers than their own souls, than their own selves. SubhanAllah. And Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also stated, adastum ta'alamun, anni awla bil mu'minina min anfusihim. Don't you know, are you not aware that I am closer to the believers than their own selves? Also Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used such words. Are you not aware that I am helper for the believers? Sahaba Akram replied, Bala ya Rasulullah, indeed ya Rasulullah, you are closer than us, you are closer to our life than we are. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are our helper, you are our supporter. SubhanAllah, at that moment, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by holding the hand of Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala, said, Man kuntu mawla, fa'alyun mawla, for whomever I am master, Ali is his master. If I am your protector, Ali is also your protector. If I am your helper, Ali is also your helper. That means, wilayat is distributed from the door of Sayyidina Ali al-Murtada radiallahu tabaraka wa ta'ala. Again, in short, do more and more ibadah. By doing more and more ibadah, we cannot be a wali of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala unless Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and his Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam blesses us with that station. But again, this month of Ramadan is also an opportunity to attain piety, to gain success. It has been made obligatory upon you to fast. كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. And this was not only for, this is not only for you. The fasting was given, the order of the fasting was given, were given to even the other nation of the previous prophets of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. For even the other ummah, this order was given. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So that you may gain piety. So that you may attain piety. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala did not say, if you observe fast, definitely you will have the piety. You will get taqwa. You will be a wali of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. But Allah Ta'ala stated, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So that you may attain piety. That means do not rely only on your ibadah. Do not rely only on your fasting, only on your prayers. But rely on the blessings of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Do ibadah. Have the expectation that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala will accept this. Have the expectation that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala will accept by the wasila of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Have this intention that may Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala accept this from me, and may Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala grant us all kinds of success. If you have this intention, then by the wasila of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the person can attain that status. SubhanAllah, my dear brothers, even after Allah has ordered him, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu taqullaha, O believers, fear Allah. After fearing Allah, Allah Ta'ala states, Wa kunu ma'as-sadiqin. Now in order to protect your iman, in order to protect your taqwa, you be with the pious servants of Allah, you be with the awliya Allah, you be with the salihin, remain with them. Subhanallah. So again, it is clear, to protect our iman, we have to be with the pious servants of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. We should have the connection with the awliya of Allah. And if we attain success by being that, inshaAllah al-Aziz, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala will make us reach that station which will be beyond the comprehension of the general people. SubhanAllah. May Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala bless all of us with such a station. And when a person reaches that station, there he has attained wilayat. By having these opportunities during the month of Ramadan, apart from Ramadan, and even in this month of Ramadan, do not just think, do not be under the idea that only by fulfilling the order of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, you can directly attain success. No, even the first 10 days of Rahmat, which is in the month of Ramadan, that is by the wasila of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even the maghfirat on the second ashara, second 10 days, that is also by the wasila of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because it is Allah who stated, Inna Allah ghafoor rahim. Indeed, Allah is the forgiver, Allah is merciful, and it is Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala who said, O my Habib, wastaghfir li dhanbika wa lil mu'minin wal mu'minat. O my Habib, you seek forgiveness for your close ones, you seek forgiveness for Muslims, male and female. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has instructed you to seek forgiveness for us, Ya Rasulullah. Also Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala stated, Wa salli alayhim. O my Habib, you pray for them. Inna salataka sakanun lahum. Indeed, your prayers is a satisfaction for the believers. Allahu Akbar. Your prayers is a sakina for them. Sakanun lahum is satisfaction for the believers. So Alhamdulillah, if we take dua of our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as forgiveness from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, then only we can attain success. And if we say, without the wasila of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we can gain everything, we are going against the Quran. Again, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala has stated, I have referred this even before, that poor people, when you have committed sin, go to the court of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, seek forgiveness from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala by being in the holy court of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Fastaghfirullah. Seek forgiveness from Allah. My Rasul has to ask forgiveness for you. My Rasul has to do shafa'at for you. Then you will find Allah as most forgiving, acceptor of the repentance. So Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala himself stated, I am the forgiver. You ask from me, I will bless you. But again Allah Ta'ala stated, oh my Habib, you seek forgiveness for them. Oh my Habib, it is because of you, I am going to forgive them. And the last 10 days to gain salvation from the hellfire, this is also by the wasila of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because if Allah Ta'ala wants, he can the chapter of Shafaat, it is clearly stated that all the people will gather on the day of judgment. They will go to Adam alayhi salam, seek help from Adam alayhi salam. They will praise Adam alayhi salam. Adam alayhi salam will say, go to Nuh alayhi salam. We all will praise Nuh alayhi salam, seek his help. And finally, we all will go to the holy court of Muhammad Rasulullah. Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Our Nabi will reply, analaha, analaha, oh my follower, I am for you. And Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated, I will perform a long sajda. I will praise Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And the words which I will use in that sajda, that will be given to me at that time by Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And those words will be such that no one has praised Allah before like that. And no one is going to praise Allah like that as I will. As I will praise Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, then Allah ta'ala will proclaim, Ya Muhammad, O my Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, raise your head, sal-ta'ata, ask if you will be given, wal-musna, you say it will be listened, wa-shafa'at, shafa, you seek shafa'at, your shafa'at will be accepted. And Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I will intercede for the people, more than the trees, more than the pebbles, more than the stones, they are in the surface of this earth, I will and the stones are on the surface of this earth. Subhanallah, again it is clear, to gain rahmat, you need Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To gain maghfirah, you need Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And to gain salvation from the hellfire, to have Jannah, you need Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Without that, a person cannot attain success. My dear brothers, after a person has attained success, if he has got piety, if he has got taqwa, Allah orders him to be with the pious servants of Allah. And has reached that status where he can be at the station of Abdar, of a Qutb, of a Ghaus. Subhanallah, now Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala blesses him with such powers which is again beyond our comprehension. Let me tell you, in light of the hadith of Sahih Bukhari, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated that Allah ta'ala says, I become the eye of my wali, my friend from which he sees. I become the ears of my wali, from which he hears. I become his hand, from which he holds. I become his feet, from which he walks. Allahu Akbar. Allah Ta'ala is free from tongue. Allah is free from eyes. Allah is free from ears, free from hands and legs. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala stated this, that I become his eyes. That means Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala blesses him with special powers, which is again beyond our comprehension. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala blesses him with such ears that they can listen to those things which we cannot listen. They can see those things which we cannot see. They can do those words which we cannot do. They can go towards a distance in a short time which we cannot do. Allahu Akbar. And also, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated, اِتَّقُوا فِرَاسَةَ الْمُؤْمِنِ فَإِنَّهُ يَمْنُ بِنُورِ اللَّهِ. Fear the vision of a wali of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, because he sees by the nur of Allah. فَإِنَّهُ يَنْظُرُ بِنُورِ اللَّهِ. When you are in front of a wali of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, fear Allah at that moment, because that wali of Allah sees by the nur of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Even we see, I can see you, you can see me, I can walk, you can walk, alhamdulillah, I can hear, you also can hear. Can anyone say these are our own powers? No, given by Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. These are common powers given by Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And when Allah ta'ala has created, I give special powers to my awliya, that means their powers are such which we cannot comprehend. They can do those works which we cannot do, because this power is also given by Allah, and that power specially is given to the friends of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And this is in light of the Holy Quran, in light of the hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they can do those things which we cannot do. Let me tell you one example. Sayyiduna Ghawsul Azam Muhammadin Abdul Qadir Jilani Qaddasallahu sirrahu al-aziz stated, Nabartu ila miladillahi jam'a Fakhaddalatin ala hukmin misali. I see the whole cities of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala as I see a mustard seed kept on my palm. The whole cities of Allah, the whole dunya in front of my eyes is like a mustard seed kept on my palm. Subhanallah, such a small seed of mustard, if you keep in your palm, just a small thing. But Ghawsul Azam radiallahu anhu states, the whole dunya for me is like this. And also Ghawsul Azam radiallahu anhu stated, that my eye is always in your bil mahfooz.
What can you see? Khaja Muhyiddin said, Oh my Shaykh, oh my beloved Shaykh, I can see up to the arsh, I can see up to the earth, the bottom of the earth, and oh my Shaykh, I can see the whole universe. My dear brothers, there can be a doubt. How come the Wali of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala can see this whole world within these two fingers? How can Ghawsul Azam radiallahu ta'ala see the whole world just as he is looking at this maya, mustard seed kept on his palm? This is again beyond our understanding, but this is a reality. Because when Allah has given them the power, who are we to object? When Allah has given them such powers, and the Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated, they see by the nur of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, then why to doubt on this? Now today, it has become more easy to understand. But Alhamdulillah, we the followers of Aqeedah of Ahlu Sunnati wal Jama'ah, we did believe, our forefathers did believe, and we do believe, inshallah, we will believe that Allah has given such powers to His awliya. But oh people, who are on doubts, who have doubts on this matter, today you have to believe, because science has reached such a high status. Science has reached that station where you are compelled to believe the maqam of awliya Allah. And if you don't believe today due to being adamant, one day you will have to believe in Imam Mahdi radiallahu ta'ala, who will control the whole world. Subhanallah. Anyhow, we did believe yesterday, we believe today, and we will believe inshallah forever. May Allah keep us firm. And those who are in doubt, they will also have to believe today. If not, one day they will believe. And even if they are ignorant, on the day of judgment they will have to believe them. At that time, there is no other choice, because dunya was the station for you to understand and repent for your mistakes. After the maut, there is no chance of repentance again. My dear brothers, today see the science of Allahu Akbar. This is very common. But let me just give you an example. I traveled to Japan 2 years before. And I was traveling from Osaka, another city. When my supplier came, he took his car, just added the telephone number or the address of the station where we wanted to go. The car started and it guides all the roads, which is the road with river, which is the road with mountain, which are the roads between the mountains. There are how many roads to go to that station, which was about 3 hours away. And it was also showing that where that particular address is located, and straight away as we were moving, it was showing the all the directions, and finally when we reached, it showed that we have reached the station. The whole thing has come into one TV, into one setup, that everything, the whole map of Japan is in that CD in such a way. You have to just put the address of the station, of the destination, or the telephone number of that station, because the telephone number contains the address of the person who has the number, and it will make you reach that station by guiding you all the roads. How many roads are there? Where is the mountain? Where is the river? Which road is easy to access? Where the traffic is? Where the traffic is less? This is called GPS. Even in Sri Lanka, we have got this facility now. I am talking about two years before, which I saw in Japan. Even about 5 years before, I saw in Taiwan. Such Allahu Akbar, my dear brothers. Further, let me tell you. Today we got this DVR system, CCTV. If you are in your office has 4 floors. You can be in your room and you can observe all the things what are happening in all your 4 floors. And if you have DVR system, you can include not 10 or 20, up to 256 cameras. You can include up to 256 cameras as per the development of science. That means that camera can be in Colombo. If you have a branch in Kandy, you can have a camera in Kandy branch. If you have an office in Sydney, you can fix the camera there. If you have a branch in Canada, you can fix the camera there. By being in your office, you can watch all those things, what is happening in Canada office, what is happening in Sydney factory, what is happening in Candy factory, what is happening in Colombo office. And okay, if you have a laptop, you can find all these things. Just forget about the laptop. Today you got the iPhone with you. In your phone, you can connect to all those 256 cameras as per the capacity of your phone, as per the memory of your phone. You can connect all those cameras in your phone. You may be driving, but you know what is happening in Sydney. You may be driving, you know what is happening in Canada. You may be driving, you know who is going trying to make a test in Canada. You can observe all those things. Not only that, that can be recorded as well. If you were unable to see at that moment while you were sleeping or while you were having your meal, you were unable to observe that. After that, you can record that back. You can reverse it back and you can replay it and you can see it during that time, during that moment, during this particular day, what happened, which person was engaged in work, who was engaged in talking with his colleague. You all can watch a being in your office or even from your mobile phone. You can watch all these things. Not only that, you can even capture the picture of a person who has left there in your Canada office by being in Colombo. You are able to capture the picture of that person. Not only that, you can send that picture as attachment to hundreds of people. You can send that picture to thousands of people by simply typing one email. My dear brothers, can you say this is our own experience? No, can you say this is our own power? This is also given by Allah Tabaraka wa Taala. Scientists, though they have researched this, but that is not at their own. Allah has given them such a knowledge that they created this. They created this. They did this and showed to the world that whole world can be under your fingertips at any given time. They have showed you that the whole world is under your fingertips. Even by Google search, you can see Google Maps, Google Earth, everything is under your fingertips. If you have a BlackBerry, you are in Colombo, your friend is in Saudi, your friend is in Canada, your friend is in Australia, still you can be connected. If he is in Singapore, his display will show that so and so friend is in Singapore, so and so friend has flown now to Dubai. You can see all these things. If they are connected to you, you are able to see if you are online. In other words, if you are in that satellite, you can do that. My dear brothers, Alhamdulillah, we are murid of Awliya Allah, we are murid of Ghawsul Azam, we are murid of Khaja Nayanam, we are murid of Sheikh Shahabuddin, Sheikh Naqshband. Alhamdulillah, Allah has given them such powers. We may be away, they can see what we are doing. We may be away, they know what we are going to do. Allah has given them such powers. And Awliya Allah, they can communicate by being at a distance. As Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu did communicate with Sayyidina Sariya radiallahu ta'ala anhu while he was in Madinah al-Munawwara. Sayyidina Sariya was in another city. This is an example. Sayyidina Asif bin Barriya, the companion of Sayyidina Sulaiman alayhi salam, he was able to see where the throne of Bilqis is located. What are the routes to reach there? How to reach there? How to go there? How to capture the throne? And how to come back to the holy court of Sulaiman alayhi salam? That is also the distance of a 2 months. He did not take 1 hour. He did not take 1 minute. He did not even take a second. Because Allah Ta'ala stated, قَبْلَ أَنْ يَرْتَدَّ إِلَيْكَ طَرْفُكَ. Asif bin Barriya said that I will bring that throne before you bat your eyelid, before you close your eyes and open. How long does it take? It doesn't even take a second to bat your eyelid. Within a second, with Allah's awliya, they can see what is happening there and what is available there and how to reach there and to bring that at the presence of Sayyidina Sulaiman alayhi salam. These are clear examples. Alhamdulillah, we did believe those things before, and these people, they will have to believe now after following the science. We did follow Quran and Sunnah. We did follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We did follow the aqidah of Sahaba. We did follow the aqidah of Imams. And true people are following the aqidah of science. At least you realize now, this is the time for you to realize when Allah has given a kafir, a Muslim, an ordinary person, a scientist, this power. Why can't Allah Ta'ala give special powers to His awliya, which is confirmed by Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? For innahu yamuru bi nurillah. They see by the nur of Allah. Again confirmed by Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. I bless them such powers in their eyes. They can see those things which you cannot see. So if this is clear, what is there to doubt on Ghawsul Azam radiallahu anhu looking at us? What is there to doubt on Khaja Nayanam looking at us? Alhamdulillah, not only looking, they are able to make us aware what other person is being. As we can make aware a third person, that my so and so person, so and so staff in Canada office, he did a mistake. I can make another person, a friend of mine who is in New York, I can make him show that by sending an email or by giving a link with my password. He can watch from his laptop, from his mobile. Similarly, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by the given power of Allah ta'ala, if awliya Allah do lend us those things, no doubt on that. This is the power given by Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. So again, let me brief you. Month of Ramadan, is a mean attain piety. And if we attain piety, if Allah Ta'ala and His Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam blesses us, we can reach the station of Wilayah. And after reaching the station of Wilayah, if Allah wills, Allah Ta'ala can select anyone to be a Qutb, to be an Abdal, to be a Ghawth. And after that, they can do those works which we cannot do, which the general common people cannot do. So my dear brothers, by the month of Ramadan, again, the main reason to fast is to gain and to attain piety, and piety is to live with Awliya Allah. So Ramadan, in other words, we can talk about Awliya Allah if we talk about Ramadan. Okay, Ramadan, fasting is a secondary ibadah after the prayers. Even in the salah, without remembering Awliya Allah, the salah is not completed. Assalamu alayna wa ala ibadillahi salihin. We are sending salam on all the Awliya Allah till the time, from the time of Adam alayhi salam till the day of judgment. We are including all the Awliya Allah in our prayers. So again, even the prayer is not accepted without remembering the Awliya Allah. So my dear brothers, this is the time to ponder. If anyone was away from the status of Awliya Allah, this is the time to repent and to remain with Awliya Allah. If you are still not satisfied, just follow the science and try to understand the Quran. This is what I can say. But Alhamdulillah, don't give science that opportunity to be your teacher, but give that opportunity that you can say Quran is my teacher, Hadith is my teacher, Awliya are my teachers, Imams are my teachers, as Alhamdulillah we did, our forefathers did, that we believed in Quran, and science is later confirming the words of the Holy Quran. So better to believe the reality first, then the next thing. Wa akhir da'wana, alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.